Aloha. My name is Professor Adriano D. Imperato. I'm the founder of the Kajukenbo Self-Defense Institute, Incorporated, in the state of Hawaii. Aloha, and welcome to the first in a series of instructional tape on the traditional method of Kajukenbo. Today, you are able to study directly from high-ranking instructors that are knowledgeable of the original and traditional techniques of the Kajukenbo system. It is my wish that all instructors and students learn these techniques so that we might standardize the system from white to black belt. Therefore, I have given my blessing to Sifu Gary Forbach, a 5th-degree black belt in the Kajukenbo system, to produce this series of instructional videotapes and to let it be known that these are the original, traditional, and pure techniques I've taught them to his master, the late Grandmaster Alejo Reyes. Good luck with your training and always work hard at it. Mahalo and aloha.
Hello, and welcome to the tape on Kajukenbo Fundamentals. My name is Gary Forbach, and I'll be guiding you through this series of Kajukenbo instructional tapes. In the beginning of all training in Kajukenbo, respect is given to the belt, the instructor, and the students, with respect to mind, body, and spirit. Also, in the beginning of all classes in the Kajukenbo system, a prayer is given. Almighty and eternal God, protector of all who put thy trust in thee, accept the humble homage of our faith and love in thee, the one true God. Bless our efforts to preserve the integrity of our United States, a nation founded on Christian principles. Enlighten our rules, guide our lawmakers, protect the sanctity of our homes, and bless our efforts in these exercises, whose sole purpose is developing our bodies to keep others of mindful of thy commandments. Give us perseverance in our actions, that we may use this as a means to get closer to you, the one true God. In the name of thy beloved Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Before training in any system, before practicing your techniques, there should always be proper warm-up. In Kajukenbo training, we start with the jumping jacks to warm the body up, stretch the muscles, approximately 50 to 100 jumping jacks. Then we go to the side bends, side to side. Forward and back. Circling to the first to the right, and then in the opposite direction back to the left. These exercises loosen up the hips, get the blood flowing, start stretching the muscles. Next exercise is for the neck, stretching the neck muscles, building the neck muscles to prevent injuries, strengthen the neck for training. Again, side to side, forward and back, and circling. Next, we move into the side stretches out of a horse stance. Move to the side. As you can see, Mark, one of my black belt students, Mark Vorba, rolling up on the heel, twisting into a horse stance, then into forward stance, switching sides, keeping the back straight, the knee over the ankle, rolling up on the heel, turning into a forward stance, stretching the hamstrings, keeping the back straight. From there, we go to back to the horse stance and into an exercise we call the splits. Down into the center split. And work yourself back, sit down, working the legs out as far as you can, stretching down in the center. As you can see, Mark is back straight. When you're moving forward, you want to make sure that you relax your breathing, relax your body, and try not to fight your stretching. Work to the sides, grabbing the ankle. And as you advance, you can try to get your chest down to your knees. And switching sides. As you can see, Mark walked himself back up, now switching from side to side on the splits. As you notice in the series, we're just basically showing you the basic exercises. Due to time on the tape, we don't have time to do the full workout, but you should be doing your exercises to your ability. Next exercise is from a horse stance into what we call a toilet bowl. Placing your index finger on your heels, keeping your back straight, down into a good stance. This works your stance, strengthens the legs. Very important to build strong legs in the Kajukenbo system for a good foundation. From there, we stay in the horse stance. As you can see, Mark's good square horse stance. The exercise he's doing is thumbs in, thumbs out. It's working your wrists, working your hands out to the sides, thumbs in and thumbs out. You want to squeeze and grab as hard as you can and go as fast as you can. Circling the wrists, loosening the wrists up, strengthening the wrists. To the sides and forward. More wrist exercises. Next exercise from a forward stance is a football swing. As you can see, Mark keeps his back straight from the forward stance, trying to keep his nose behind his belly button. Switching sides, same thing. Beginning students should do approximately 10 on each side, advanced students 20 to 50. Also out of a forward stance is an outside crescent. Again, you can see Mark keeping his back straight to the side. This gives you flexibility in your hips for various kicks and movements that are used in the techniques in the Kajukenbo system. As you can see, any exercise that's done in our training is done on both sides. This exercise is done for cardiovascular fitness. Stay on your toes, hopping up and down, side to side, forward and back. We do this approximately five to seven minutes, working on cardiovascular fitness. Gives you agility for sparring and movement. Switching the legs forward and back. This exercise is called a supercharger. It's also for cardiovascular fitness. You can see the knees are to come up above the belt. Lower abdomen and abdomen training is very important in any martial art, especially the Kajukenbo system, building strong stomachs. Flutter kicks, as Mark just demonstrated, in our training we do approximately 200. Various sit-ups, also, again, done to your ability. Straight leg, bent knee. Raising the knees up to the elbows. Push-ups. Various types of push-ups. First was demonstrated regular push-ups. Diamond push-ups, as you can see here, Mark's putting his nose down and trying to touch his fingers. Works on your forearms. Fingertip push-ups. Used to build a strong grip. Wrist push-ups. All push-ups, approximately 10 to 20, according to your ability. Knuckle push-ups. Placing the first two knuckles down. One-hand push-up. Switch sides. And to stretch the back in the opposite direction, an arch push-up. Again, we do approximately 10 to 20 of each of these. And the cobra. Stretching the lower back. Also in Kajukenbo system are the ki exercises. This is one that most students dread seeing coming, but it builds strength in the stomach, teaching you how to be able to take a punch to the stomach. Next exercise, conditioning for the forearms, called samsing. Stances. Stances will be demonstrated by Suzette Tirado. Horse stance. As you notice, before Suzette went into the horse stance, she did the squatting position, which is characteristic of the Kajukenbo system. Now into a forward stance. The knee is directly over the ankle, back leg locked, keeping your back straight. Hands are in an elbow smash position. Cat stance. And the tiger stance. This stance is used mostly in sparring. As you can see, she's on the ball of the back foot to be able to push off and spring forward. Next, we'll demonstrate rolling and falling and basic falling techniques, the tumbling. These techniques are used in the system because of our judo and jiu-jitsu techniques. Don Crummer is demonstrating a forward roll, and as you can see, his feet are in a figure four position, so he does not have to use his hands to come up. As you can see, the head's tucked, feet are in the figure four position without having to use the hands. And always covering to your rear. Roll and cover. Now we have a demonstration of how the roll is applicated in case someone comes from behind, pushes you. As anyone who's experienced on the street knows, most fights or assaults end up on the ground, and these rolls are very important to pay attention to. Next, the next roll is a shoulder roll, forward shoulder roll. Rolling diagonally from the right shoulder to the left hip. Again, as you can see, Don Crummer's feet are in a figure four position, up into a cover stance. Stepping forward with the right leg, reaching down with the right hand in between his legs, tucking the chin, pushing off with the back foot, rolling into figure four and up. Now to the left. As you can see, the roll's done diagonally across the back from the left shoulder to the opposite hip. These rolls are unique of the Kajukenbo system. As you can see again, someone attacking from behind, diagonal roll, and he's right back up on his feet without using his hands. Next is a back roll. Dropping down, tucking the chin, rolling, covering, and back up on the feet. Assailant pushes from the front. Don's able to roll and recover. Now to the falls. The low back fall. As you can see, Don's hands are crossed. He's slapping to the side. His hands are close to his hips. And as he goes down, he's got his legs crossed to keep the assailant from kicking the groin. Hands come up and cross, tucking the chin, slapping to break the fall. Back up without using the hands. As you slap, you should also ki-ai, always ki-ai. This also helps break the impact of the fall, helps you keep you from losing your breath. Beginning students practice the low back fall. Also, advanced students always practice these falls. No matter how good you get, you should always practice your falls. Always practice the basics. Mark pushes Don, he covers, and he's unable to kick. Here they're demonstrating a basic technique that could be used. Next is the right and left side low falls. As you can see, Don grabs his left knee, extends the right foot, and slaps with the right hand, ki-eyeing as he drops to the mat. Opposite side, same thing. The hand comes up, crosses the body, the slap with the ki-eye, back up, without using the hands, and cover. All students should train themselves to cover. Mark pushes Don. He does a right side back fall with a back roll, and he's up. He's able to get it back up on his feet and cover. High falls. These falls are for more advanced students. They shouldn't be tried by anyone that hasn't practiced. Here Mark's doing a handstand fall. These falls are practiced to teach someone, you know, teach a student how to take a fall from a throw, someone throwing you some type of a judo throw or a flip or something. Next we have blocking, basic blocking techniques of the system. Squatting position, down into a horse stance. Always practice your blocks from a horse stance. Basic outward block. Blocking the face. As you can see, my hand comes up, crossing the face, blocking whatever is coming in, whether it be a punch or it doesn't matter what it might be. Blocking across the face. Always elbow smash hard as you're blocking. Your breath should never be held also in any of these exercises. You should always be breathing. Also, in all these techniques, the arm and the hand, the body should be relaxed until the last 6 inches. Then it tightens and snaps. Application against a basic punch. Block. Stepping back and blocking to the outside. Block, counter punch. Next is the upward block. The hand comes across the front of the body and up. Always watch your block. Always keep your eye on the block. Again, relaxed except till the last 6 inches. Block and counter. As you can see, Don is a advanced student, uses his falls even when he's practicing. Next is the inward block. Hand comes up by the ear and across. Snaps the last 6 inches. It's one of the most common blocks in martial arts. Again, always breathe with your blocks. Exhale as you're blocking. Never holding your breath. Now application. Sidestepping into a horse stance. Block. Counter. Next block is the long outward block, crossing the body, protecting the body, and blocking out and away from your body. Downward block, This block's normally used for countering against kicks. And as you can see, the opposite hand is always back in the elbow smash position, ready for the next move. Stepping back, countering. Next block is the X or cross block, used downward and upward. Beginning students should always remember to keep their hands in a tight fist when they're using this type of a block. Actually, beginning students should always keep their hands in a fist, protecting the fingers and the wrists from injury. As you can see, this block's used, it's a very strong block against weapon attacks, but you should always block the arm and never block the weapon. Again, looking where you're blocking and being aware of the position of the weapon. Next block is a more advanced block known as a brush block. The purpose of the brush block is to redirect the motion of the punch or the attack. As you can see, it's just a light tapping block just to redirect the motion of the attack. Next, we have punching techniques, basic punches that are used in the Kajukenbo system. Demonstrating the punches is Michelle Rosales. Forward punch. As you can see, she never totally extends the arm, always keep it slightly bent. Shoulders stay straight. Back is straight, so you don't extend your balance. Application: upward block, forward punch. Actually, reverse punch. Always keep the wrist straight. Next is a vertical punch. This is used mostly into the sternum or the solar plexus, or used as a jab. As you can see, her wrists stay straight, keep it from bending and injury, possible breaking it. Next is a poke to the eyes or eye jab. As you can see, the thumb is in, fingers are slightly spread to penetrate the eyes. I highly recommend this type of strike for women, more so than the punch. Next strike, palm heel. Using the heel of the palm as your striking point. This is one of the strongest types of strikes you can use because you're not involving the hand, the smaller bones of the hand. It's very strong, very powerful for women. You can see the thumbs in, fingers slightly bent. As you can see, it's very effective with Michelle blocking the attack, striking the solar plexus. Naturally, Dawn moves down and then up to the chin. Next is a chop or the shudo. Strike's done with the blade of the hand, thumb in. And as you can see, the hands are kept straight. Striking with the blade of the hand. Strike is used mostly to the neck, but also can be used to the ribs, other various parts of the body. In practicing the strike, it should be practiced directly underneath the ear. Next is the ridge hand. Using the inside of the hand. Mostly, this is also used either to the neck, to the face, the back of the neck. Kidneys, back of the neck.
Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes.
Next strike is the elbow. Using the elbow and the forearm for striking. Very powerful technique. Extremely powerful. Probably one of the most powerful techniques in martial arts.
Yes!
in the solar plexus into the face. I'd like to point out that these are all basic strikes, blocks, and exercises that we're demonstrating. There are many other strikes in the Kajukenbo system, but they're used in the advanced levels of training. The purpose of this tape is to teach the fundamentals and basic training to beginning students. Next, we have the kicking techniques, basic kicks used in the Kajukenbo system. First, the forward snapping kick. Kicks will be demonstrated by black belt instructor Mark Vorba. So you can see, he's kicking with the ball of the foot, toes are back, protecting the toes, keeping them from breaking, snapping. Kick comes out and snaps back in to keep your opponent or your assailant from grabbing, trapping the leg. You lift the knee up, snap the kick out, bring the kick back in, and set your foot down. In practicing, you must make sure that you use proper form so you don't develop bad habits. Again, beginning students should do approximately 10 on each leg. Advanced students can go anywhere from 30 to 50 on each leg. Application of the snapping kick can be used to the knee, the groin. Stomach. On the street, in Kajukenbo techniques, there are rarely any kicking techniques above the belt or above the waist. For reality on the street, I believe that kicking to the head is like punching to the knee. Next kick, forward thrust kick. As you can see, the application is basically the same. However, this is a power kick used mostly for knockdown. You drive through your opponent or your assailant. It's a very powerful kick, extending the knee and almost locking the knee. I recommend that especially beginners and anybody actually use a bag to make contact when they're practicing their kicks so to prevent injuries to the knee. Those of you that aren't familiar with the Kajukenbo system can see the students that are they're making contact to the body. We believe that it's very important to make contact because of the reality on the street. One thing you must remember, these are advanced students. Most of them have trained over 10 years. As you can see, Mark's back stays straight, maintaining his balance. As you can see here, Mark uses the extension of his leg to reach in, kick the assailant in the solar plexus before the assailant's able to reach him with his weapon. Next is a side snapping kick. This kick is it's performed with the blade of the foot. Toes are back, snapping with the side of the foot or the blade of the foot. As you can see here, he's lifting the knee up, snapping the kick out, bringing it back in and setting it down. Foot's turned, toes are up, the blade of the foot, not the bottom, and not the heel, but the blade of the foot. The foot's turned sideways as it's extended. Here you can see the application of the kick. Foot snaps out, snaps back. It's a very fast and effective kick. Next, the side thrust kick. This kick is performed the same way as a side snapping kick, but you're extending the heel. Again, this kick's used for a power kick, a knockdown power kick. It's very powerful. Extending the knee and locking the leg out. As I said before, I highly recommend the use of a bag and practicing these kicks to prevent injuries to the knee. As you can see, the knee is locked and the kick's held up momentarily, as opposed to the side kick. As you can see, the kick has very high knockdown power. This is a mule or the back kick, back thrusting heel kick. Lifting the knee forward, extending the heel, kicking straight behind you. Used in case of an attack from the rear. You can see Don leans forward, lifting his knee, extending the heel. Eliminating the assailant. Just as in all the rest of the fundamentals and basics in training, students should never hold their breaths. You should always learn how to relax your breathing and extend your breathing. Always keep breathing during your techniques. Next kick is a roundhouse or wheel kick. should be practiced from the forward stance, bringing the foot straight forward as if you're doing a forward kick, pivoting on the opposite foot, on the ball of the opposite foot, swinging the foot around, kicking with the ball of the foot, with your toes back. Leg comes forward, pivot, snap to kick, bring it back in, pivot back, and resume your fighting stance. This kick is very deceptive. Next is a knee. Just like the elbow, the knee is a very powerful weapon. Knee can be used to the groin, to the thigh, the trunk, and especially to the head. Here you see practical application of all the fundamentals we've demonstrated. Double upward blocks, snapping groin kick, and a knee to the head. Next, spinning heel kick. This is a more advanced kick. I don't really recommend beginning students try to practice this kick until they've basically mastered the other kicks that we've shown on the series. As you can see, I'm spinning the upper body first, looking where I'm kicking, pivoting on the forward foot, and going back into my stance. Very important that you spin the upper body to get the momentum, just like a top. As you'll see here in slow motion, my upper body pivots, stepping back with the back foot, get the shoulders going, looking where I'm kicking, hooking, and back into my fighting stance. This kick's mostly practiced for balance and use in tournament fighting. I don't really recommend the use of it on the street, especially for beginners. Like the wheel kick, again, it's a very deceiving kick. It's hard to read for your opponent. If you master this kick, it can be a really strong kick for you. Here you can see the application of the kick. Pulling punches, spinning hook and heel kick to the head. Next kick is called a funny kick. It's done with the instep of the foot. Kicks aimed for the groin. As you can see, the kick's thrown and then the body follows. It's not a hopping kick. The kick comes and then the body follows. This kick is used mainly in competition and to the groin to draw the opponent's attention and his hands down so that you can use your hands to go to the upper body. You can see Mark's kick coming in. Again, demonstrated the groin, the stomach, and then chest. Oh! Again, remember to practice these kicks on each side, left and right, approximately 10 to 20 times on each leg according to your ability. And remember, all the techniques shown on this tape are the basic fundamentals of the Kajukenbo system. The purpose of the tape is to help beginning students to recognize basic techniques and practice at home. This concludes the tape on Kajukenbo basic fundamentals. We hope you will train hard and practice hard. We also hope you will continue with the further tapes offered on the Kajukenbo system.